the Police Officer Memorial Remembrance Service, honoring the ultimate sacrifice of New York's finest. The event began at a service at St. Mary's Church, and then a procession of police officers marched to the police memorial at the Empire State Plaza. This year, 26 police officers were added to the memorial. Officers came from 6 local, state, and federal law enforcement agencies.
Yes, and I think the ones that we probably remember the most are the 2 police officers that were gunned down last year, both of them shot in the head. Police Officer Holder and his family. I was at the funeral for the family and with the father and the mother, and at the memorial wall where we put all the names of each one of these heroes on the wall, and that will be there for eternity. And we keep the light shining for these families and their names, so we never forget what they did in their service. We also had a Donald Friedenberg, who was out of University of Albany, who was himself died, and another gentleman, Sergeant Eric O'Meara, both also died in the line of duty. But these officers being shot down the way they were, just horrendous. And of course, 19 of them being placed on the wall from 9/11. 9/11, people seem to forget how many people we are burying. And this is 19 that we put on the wall of police officers and city and federal offices. Now, we have, tomorrow is EMS day, so we have our emergency medical technicians being on it. A number of them that responded, a number of people in the community, the volunteers, the iron workers, the guys that, the laborers that went in there that worked day in and day out, that they're dying, and you know, they're not going on this wall. We got, you know, so we don't want to forget about their service and what they went through. And today, there are many people sick with many of these cancers, and that's why we do the Scroter Act down at the Washington level, that where the federal government passed it, but we do it at the state level to add the different cancers that are developed because of 9/11, and to make sure that they are acknowledged and that their families are taken care of and that the services are there for them physically and mentally and spiritually, to make sure that we get the families through these tough times, and when that poor person goes home or succumbs to the disease, that we're there to take care of the family and to make sure that we never forget those heroes. So we go to funerals on a regular basis. And we're going to continue for a number of years to go to these funerals. And as I said, it's probably, you know, I talked about Sandy on the earlier event, some of the most horrendous thing that I've seen. But in our lifetime for this nation, September 11th, the infamy, that is the what we've seen happen in Pearl Harbor years ago, and what we've seen the war going on in Europe, and World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, and all the subsequent wars from since then. You're going to, this will go down and never be forgotten, because this is the biggest tragedy that ever happened. 3,000 people gave their lives for this great nation. They didn't know it that day that they were going to die. They didn't know they were going to be sick 10 years later. But they were there, and they suffered because of the heinous acts of terrorism that go on a daily basis around this world. We as a nation have to do more. We as a city and a state have to do more. And I want to give it up for my veterans out there and all those that are listening and going into the services this very day. And those that are serving today overseas, I want to say thank you very much for your service. But this is, you know, one of the reasons that we fought. That's why we live in the greatest city and the greatest nation in the world, is because of the sacrifices of our men and women and the sacrifices that these individuals made on 9/11. They're going to save their brothers and sisters that they believed would... Had an opportunity to be saved, but as the days went by, we knew that it was hopeless and it wasn't going to happen. But our prayers go out to their families. We're there to help and work with them, and all of our police and fire and EMTs that sacrifice so much each and every day for us and keep us safe in our homes at night. So to the police officers, God bless them, and to the fire and our EMTs as well.
So I have to say, as you're remembering these fallen officers, you were an officer in the NYPD, and you were severely injured while making an arrest. So does that enter your mind?
Well, I got to tell you, you never know. I had one of those clouds. There were certain officers who used to go out there when we used to get involved on a regular basis. I would be involved. I was the North Lot of Arrests and was well honored by the New York City Police Department. It was the greatest loss leaving that job. If I could, I'd still be there. I think it was the greatest job I ever had. Loved being a senator, but being a police officer, you took a bad guy off that street or out of that apartment. The house became better. The block became better. The neighborhood became better. So you wanted to keep that safety and give people that concern or take those concerns away from them that they weren't in safe communities. So I really loved that job. But it happens. You don't know what's going to happen. Tomorrow morning, tonight, later today, police officers can go down. So it's sacrifices that are made, and they don't get paid an awful lot of money for their sacrifices. This is not a well-paid job. It's they got 1% raises, which is very, very sad. So I feel sorry for them, and why others got 40 and 50% raises in salaries. And so it's very, very sad in the city of New York to see what our cool cops and firemen, and across the state, what they're getting paid this very day and what their sacrifices are for them, for their families, and, of course, for our communities.
Yeah. I want to end this program with part of the ceremony where the 26 officers were called out one by one. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you very much, Julia.
Thanks, Senator.
Ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished guests, it's an honor, and a heartbreaking honor, to read the names of these fallen heroes whose names are memorialized here. May we always remember them and never forget their sacrifice. From the Town of Crawford Police Department, Eric O. Meyer. From the New York City Police Department, James J. Albanese, Stephen J. Bonanno, James M. Burke, Peter D. Chachio, Louis G. Fernandez, Stuart F. Fishkin, James Guida, Randolph A. Holder, Cheryl D. Johnson, Robert W. Kaminsky, Sean M. Mahoney, Brian R. Moore, Patrick P. Murphy, Peter O. Rodriguez, John A. Russo, Stephen P. Scalza, Scott V. Stelmach, Richard H. Wentz. From the New York State Police, Donald R. Friedenberg, Jr., Thomas G. Moran, Jr. From the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation Police, Harvey B. Cruikshank, Benning W. De La Mater, Paul J. Duquesnoy. From the United States Marshal Service, Zacharias Toro, Jr. And from the City of Yonkers Police Department, Roy D. McLaughlin.